Hey everyone, Blake LaGrange here from Mastering.com. Today we're chatting with Jeff Bowler. In this video, we're going to take a look at how he was able to actually, within 4 weeks, recoup his investment in this program and actually step up his game and offer this service to just some great paying clients and just get industry standard sounding stuff. So obviously we know each other and we've been working with one another, but for those who have no idea who you are, do you want to just give like a brief kind of overview, background of who you are, what you're doing, whether you're a musician or producer or whatever, just kind of give people a high level about who you are and what you're doing.
Yeah, so I'm musician first, and I'm an engineer, kind of a producer. I just started this year going full-time with doing audio production, doing mixing, mastering, tracking people. Until the lockdown, I was doing some live sound stuff as well. So
out of interest, I guess, what kind of music do you like to engineer, and what you're a musician, so what's kind of your space?
Yeah, so I kind of live in like the punk world a little bit. So hardcore punk, pop punk, just kind of garage rock type stuff, things right. Like that.
Yeah.
Anything that loud and aggressive mostly.
That's the one thing we bonded over when I heard your music. I was like, oh, I'm such a sucker for this kind of stuff. So very cool. Okay, so that's your background. That's who you are. That's what you're doing. You've been diving into this sort of full time the beginning of this year. Is that what you said?
Yes, first year full time.
Got it. Okay, super cool. So I guess let's talk about right before you and I chatted and right before you started to dive into the Mastering Accelerator. I guess let's just transport back to that. Right before that moment, what were the main problems that you were hearing in your masters? What were the main problems you were hearing in your engineering? What were the main things that motivated you to dive in? I mean, kind of where were you at on your skill level and all of this before you dove in?
I was pretty much just mastering completely wrong because I didn't really understand mastering 100%. Like, I knew why you want mastering and things like that, but I was kind of mastering and mixing at the same time because I didn't really know how to master correctly without just destroying my mixes. So I just kind of integrated it as a part of my mixing process. And that just really made things really hard, especially if I was doing things like an EP or an album or something like that, trying to make all the songs sound like they go together and belong together as one, you know, one album or one EP. It's really, really difficult. And at the time, right before I joined the Mastering Accelerator, I was just diving in deep on YouTube tutorials, things like that, just trying to wrap my head around mastering. And one morning I woke up with an email from Brian Hood from the Six Figure Home Studio talking about your course. And I set up a phone call with you, and you know, the rest is just kind of history.
Cool. Yeah. I love Brian. We love him there. Good friend. What he's doing is awesome. Props to him. I'm sure you could speak also very highly of him as well, but yeah.
No idea. I'll run, you know, this as a business if it wasn't for them. So
yeah. Yeah. No, Brian's the man. So, and you're obviously perfect to take that because it's what you do. Okay. So that's kind of where you were before. So you dove in relatively recently. It's not like you've been, you know, at this for a few years with me, but you're in it, right? I mean, you're going through things and things are happening and things are being different and transformed in your mind. I guess before we get to where you're at currently of like your skill set and how you're able to overcome a lot of things, just give a kind of a, maybe a big picture or even like more details about what it was like for you to dive in, what it's been like, what have you liked about it? What has totally changed your mind? Do you like the Q&As? Do you like the content? Well, I mean, whatever you want, man, just kind of explain what your experience.
Yeah, for me, the number one thing that's made this all worth it is the Q&As. Like, the coursework is awesome, and it's a lot, which is great. Like, it says 9 weeks. It's going to take me a lot longer in 9 weeks. That's for sure. Still on week four or something like that. Like, there's just, you know, you have homework for, like, every single video, which is great. It's, you know, I've probably done more mastering since starting this than, like, the last 2 years or so. So
sure. That's,
but I would pay the money again to get this just for the Q&A, even if I didn't have the course, just because being able to like have someone to just listen to what I'm working on, especially when I'm having trouble with mixes, I'm having trouble with things. I don't think there's a single thing that you've told me that hasn't just like 100% worked. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's encouraging, man. I'm curious to know more about that because obviously I love our Q&A times and I'm just like a big sucker for your music, of course, as well. I mean, of course, we're able to bond over that, even give you like a little recommendation of an album to listen to. But in terms of what you found beneficial, I guess like I'm curious to know what were the moments in kind of our conversations that you've really been like a takeaway, whether it's like you can share a story or you can share like particular thing that you and I discussed that really helped. I mean, just dive in a little bit deeper.
In specific, like sure. Biggest thing that's happened to me thus far is I had a mix that I showed you. I had already sent it to the client. He had already started getting his revisions ready for me. I sent it to you. You gave me like 4 simple things to do. I did it. I told the client, hey, I let someone listen to this and like I made some changes. I sent the mix back to them and he had no revisions for me after the mix I sent you. All of his revisions were taken care of before he even sent them to me, just based off what you told me to do.
Interesting. So you sent it off and you're pretty proud of it. And then once we kind of looked at it together, it sounds like his revisions were, there was no revisions. It sounded like it just kind of went away because you identified all the cool things in it.
Yeah, everything he was going to tell me to make changes to, you caught and told me before he could tell me. And he like, this is perfect. Like, we'll use it as it is. You don't have to change anything.
Well, you're a great engineer, so that makes a lot of sense too. I mean, people are loving what you're doing. So, I mean, yeah, what else, man? I mean, what has been really, I guess, beneficial or specific takeaways that have changed your mental template or your skill set or your confidence? I mean, anything. I mean, anything specific, feel free to share.
So my mastering has changed already, even though I haven't even gotten to EQ or compression or dynamics or anything like that. Just by being on the call and hearing what you say to other people who are asking questions, I'm just picking up little bits of information. I'm not trying to master as part of the mix anymore. One, just the way the gain staging things, I haven't even gotten there, but I've heard you talk to people about gain staging throughout, you know, compression, things like that. And just applying those, I'm using way less of my limiter than I was before to get the volume I want, which is cool. I had a problem, you know, last week with a song that had really bad just AC hum in the background. Right. And I asked for a suggestion for a plugin. I went and got it and it worked perfectly.
Oh, totally good. I was wondering about that. That's good.
Completely fixed the problem for me. It was awesome. You know, just things and the way I talk to clients now, of just like the questions I ask, the way I ask for reference tracks, you know, on one of our first calls, I asked you about that. And you said, if I'm, you know, tracking and mixing and mastering, to just ask for a reference that's like an artistic reference.
Right.
And then that's a sonic one. And that has been game changing too, like understanding why the clients are using these references and things like
right.
that. All the questions, like in the video where you give us the Google Docs link to, you know, all the questions you ask, being able to just use those myself, it's been awesome.
That's great. So yeah, it seems like you've kind of gleaned the content, at least the part of the content that has helped reframe expectations for clients. I mean, because you're working in the industry, working with clients, it seems like from the beginning, able to refine your communication process with your clients is kind of what you're referring to and what you've seen improvement on. So that's fantastic. That's awesome, dude. So I guess, you know, I think you said week 4. So you're not quite halfway there yet, or just right at halfway. Of course, it kind of gets more and more intense as we keep going. But I guess what are the things, I'm sure you poked around and like you're sort of noticing things in your masters and things that you're wanting to dial in and try to experiment on and hone in on. What are the things, I guess, within your mastering and the content and all this that you're most looking forward to?
Just getting better at it, you know, just getting my masters to a place where they're what I hear in my head, you know, getting my masters to a place where they're what I know I'm capable of doing, but just haven't figured out how to get there quality wise yet.
For sure. Yeah. And I mean, I've already seen a ton of improvement from you already, even though you're only halfway through. I'm super confident you'll get there, obviously, but and because you're somebody who takes action and you'll make it happen either way. In terms of, I guess, where you're at right now, I mean, I know you're not finished and I know you never really finish this program. I mean, there's content, of course, but the lifetime kind of mentorship is something that you can come back to whenever you want and do. But I guess you're sort of halfway through. So for those thinking, okay, what's it like for somebody halfway through? What are the results you'd expect from that? I mean, where are you, I guess, today in terms of your mastering skill set, your abilities, your clients, your prices? I mean, anything. And how does it compare to, I guess, before you jumped in?
I feel way more confident. I trust myself more in what I'm hearing. I'm doing far less car check. I'm doing far less, you know, let me listen to this again in the morning and see how I feel about it. I mean, Sonar Works is a huge part of that, and that being a part of the course is awesome. I didn't really realize how big of a difference that would make, but, you know, I feel far more confident in what I'm doing for my clients and my abilities, even just 4 weeks in, than I did before I started the course.
Sure, yeah. And I mean, you mentioned something about Sonar Works in your room. I'm curious to hear your take on it. Of course, I remember this as well, where we kind of looked at your room kind of one-on-one, uploaded pictures, and like we saw something in your sub and like started to diagnose that problem. I'm sure you'd be able to experience the benefits of all of that way more than I have, obviously, because you're working in your room. But I guess, could you kind of unpack that story or unpack that sort of experience or aha moment for you? I'm just curious to hear how you would put it.
I've had a sub this whole time, and it's been out face this whole time. I didn't realize it. It's so, like, now I can actually hear the low end, which is great. I'm still working to get dialed in, you know. The big thing for me was I had a huge dip in like the upper mid range that I didn't realize. That's like super important, especially with the music I'm working right on, to get upper mid range correct.
Right.
And Sonar has just really helped that. I'm not in the most perfect environment. Eventually, I want to get into a better space. But cool thing to me is that it gives you different EQ curves for the left and right. Really helped a lot because I was having differences within. It almost sounds like the speakers are like, I'm more in the middle and it's more balanced, you know?
Sure. Yeah, totally.
There were times where it felt like the right speaker might have been a little bit quieter than the left or something like that. And
right.
Just, it's like taking the blindfold off,
right.
You know, I can hear everything now way, way more clearly.
For sure. And now you're able to make obviously more objective decisions and trust yourself more. And I remember it's interesting. Your setup was very, we had to troubleshoot it quite a bit, but it was basically like this. You had your speakers and I said, okay, do a reading of like where your speaker's at now. Cause we looked at the curve on everything with the room treatment and we're like, okay, something's off. And then it's like, okay, upload a picture of with the sub on. And then like, wait a second, you're getting less low end with the sub on. What's going on here? And we're like, oh, there's a phase invert. Okay, go flip that, upload this. And it's like, okay, boom, there it is. Okay, now we'll need to, I remember we had to like, okay, now go and move the crossover down to 50 hertz instead of 100 and whatever. So we really kind of personally, I guess, diagnosed your room together. So how has that been? I mean, I don't think we've talked since you've done all that. Have you been able to do all that?
I am doing it tomorrow, actually. I've had work, you know, this week.
That's good.
Great. So, like I haven't gotten around to it, but I'm totally happy with the reason why I haven't gotten around to it. So,
good problem to have, yeah.
Yeah, but just even just flipping the phase on it and just getting the low end and, like, it just helps so much. Like I could hear it as I was running the Sonar Works test. I could tell there was a lot more low end just from hearing the Sonar Works do its little, you know, noises that sends out and stuff. It's been really good, you know. I really enjoyed it and all the help that you've given. There's no like gatekeepery, like, you know, you're willing to 100% share all your knowledge and 100% just like work through multiple Q&A calls to try to get this right with me. And it's just been awesome.
Yeah. I mean, it's fun and easy too when somebody like you who's going to take action and do it and like implement it. So it's just a joy to see because you're going to take yourself seriously when you do it and actually take action. I guess, what would you say to those who are thinking about diving into what you did, like Accelerator, they're sort of on the fence, maybe they're a musician or engineer and pretty good at what they do and, you know, all of this stuff. And they're wanting to step up their mastering game. And they're like, I don't know if I should do this. Like, what, I guess, would you recommend this? Like, what would you say to them?
Yes. So I'd recommend it under the condition that you're actually serious about it.
Yeah.
Like, if you're not fully committed to it, it's just so, it's a 9-week program. It's a lot, and there's a lot of homework. But if you're going to actually commit to it and follow through with it, and if you're someone who's serious about, you know, you're not just trying to get it to be okay, you're right, trying to get actually good sounding masters, I would 100% recommend it. I mean, I've even tried telling engineer friends of mine to like get on it, you know, people I work with on like a daily basis and stuff. So
that's cool, man. Yeah. I mean, I agree with you too, that you should not do this unless you're committed to it, because, you know, you have to bet on yourself. It's a lot of work and it's a roadmap for sure. And if you do everything right, it's going to pay out for you. But you're right. I think it's not something, it's not entertaining. It's you know,
not quick. It's no. going to take a lot of work to get to where you want to be. But if you right. want, you're going to put that work in, 100% do it. 100%.
Yeah. I mean, that's encouraging to hear, man. I'm so like, congrats to the success you've had so far. I love that you've been having work and you've been using this and utilizing this and it's paying off. So that's fantastic. I mean, I'm curious to know this. I mean, you're a great engineer, great musician. There might be people who are in your shoes, maybe a few steps behind you. What advice have you received or that you would like to give? Like, what would you say to those people, just from one producer, one engineer to another, one musician to another, to help them succeed? Any like personal advice you'd give them?
So based off of me, it's don't be afraid to like take those steps and to try those things. Like, I was pretty cautious like joining this, because it, you know, it is a big investment, and it's, but 4 weeks in, I've already got my money's worth, you know. And like, the number one thing is like, don't stop trying, you know, don't give up. Have that sort of mentality that there is work out there, that you can do this, that you can make money doing this, that you can make living doing this. You know, I can't tell you how many mornings I've woken up with no work coming up, and then by the end of the day had the next week booked up. You know, I mean, it's just, you gotta trust that this will actually work out and not be afraid to take that sort of leap.
Yeah, and I agree with you. I think any success that I've had, it's basically been because I've been able to take risks and take leaps and just walk through doors that are hard to do. And when you dive into anything, right, whether it's building a studio or joining this or whatever, it's like, you're taking a risk. You're betting on yourself. So, and you've done that. You've taken action. You're killing it. And I just think you're going to continue crushing it. And I'm personally, obviously, committed to helping you along the way. I'm a huge fan of you. And I think you're just going to keep doing what you're doing. So cheers, my glass of water.
But cheers.
Cool, man. Is there anything else you'd like to say? I mean, now's your chance. You don't have to, but is there anything else you'd like to say?
I mean, just if you really want better masters, then join the course. You know, even if you're not trying, even if you have like good masters and good mixes, just the ability to talk to somebody who's been doing this longer and who, you know, getting that info from you for very specific things too, to be able to bring up very specific issues and problems and have you give me feedback on them. Just, you know, sign up for the course.
Well, I appreciate the encouragement, man. I mean, if people do what you're doing, which is take action, bet on yourself, and just do the work, you're going to see success. And so I think you should just continue to do that, and you will. Dude, thanks for chatting. It's been awesome chatting with you, man. It's always a pleasure chatting with you.
Yeah.